Hello, and welcome to this presentation on backing up and restoring the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager environment. In this video, you will learn about the engine backup command utility and the options used in the backup and restore process, the scheduling of automatic backups to demonstrate backing up the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager engine host, and to demonstrate restoring the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager environment from a backup. To backup and restore the engine, we use the engine-backup command utility. This utility comes with many options for backing up and restoring your environment. To view the usage and available options, use the command engine-backup --help. In this video, we examine the mode, scope, file, and log options. For the command option --mode=, the available parameters are backup, restore, or verify. The backup mode creates a gunzip backup file in the /var/lib/overt/overt-engine-backup directory by default. The restore mode restores the system from a backup file. The verify mode runs a checksum of the contents in the backup file. The --scope option specifies what to backup, and we can request multiple scopes with the same command. The all parameter indicates a complete backup or restore of the system. With the files parameter, you indicate that you want to backup or restore the product files only. The DB and DWDB parameters specify whether to only backup the database or data warehouse databases. The file parameter specifies the file name to use for the backup or to restore from. The log parameter specifies the name of the log file to create during the backup or restore process. Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager does not automatically backup your system. You can use the cron utility, for example, to schedule and automate the backing up of your environment. For more information on the cron utility, refer to the Oracle Linux Administrator's Guide. In this video, we will backup and restore the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager by using the engine-backup command utility. So now let's start by creating a backup. Here we are logged into the DG_LVM-TRNG instance on our Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. This is our engine host running the engine-backup utility. As root, we enter the command engine-backup --mode=backup --file=\var\lib\over-engine-backup\engine-backup --log=\var\lib\over-engine-backup\engine-backup.log to create a full backup of the system. Based on the path specified, a backup file and log file for our manager are created. Shortly after, a message appears at the bottom of the output stating that the backup of the manager host is done. To view the backup and log files, we change directories to the /var/lib/overt-engine-backup directory. Running the command ls-l, we see the two files created, the backup file and the log file. Now we will restore the system from a full backup of the manager. For this demonstration, I will run the engine-cleanup utility to simulate a catastrophic loss of the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager. This utility removes the configuration files and cleans the database associated with the manager. The cleanup utility requires us to respond interactively to the prompts. We begin by typing engine-cleanup from the command line in a terminal window. When requested to remove all components, we enter the default of yes. At the next prompt, we are warned that all installed overt components will be removed and the data will be lost. We input OK to remove these items. Several more info messages scroll by until we are notified that the cleanup is completed successfully. Now let's try and log back into the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager. At the login screen, I enter my credentials. A service unavailable page displays indicating the manager is not available. Now let's restore our manager and its databases. This will be a two-step process. First, we restore the system from our backup file and then perform setup and configuration operations to complete the recovery process. To restore the required components of the manager, we run the engine-backup utility again. We input the command engine-backup --mode equals restore --scope equals all --file equals /var/lib/overt-engine-backup/engine-backup --log equals /var/lib/overt-engine-backup/engine-backup.log --restore-permissions to restore a full backup of the manager. We can see this time the mode is restore and the scope is all for everything. For the file, we tell it the location of our tar archive to restore from, and for the log, the path to the log file. We also use the parameter --restore-permissions. This restores the permissions of the database users and is required when restoring a backup. We run the command. Note there is a caution message stating that any changes made to the environment after the date of the backup will probably require recovery or recreation. With the restore complete, we run the engine-setup command. The engine-setup utility performs setup and configuration of the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager. Configuration options require user input. For this video, we will accept all default values. The first prompt is to configure the firewall. We accept with yes. Then we say yes when prompted to back up the existing database, and no when prompted to perform a full vacuum of engine history database. We enter OK when prompted to accept the configuration settings. At the end of the last server info messages is a notification that the setup completed successfully. We go back to the browser window with the service unavailable page displayed and refresh the window. The Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager login screen displays, and we log in to the dashboard page and can see all the components restored. In this video, you learned about the engine-backup command utility and the options used in the backup and restore process, the scheduling of automatic backups, to demonstrate backing up the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager engine host, and to demonstrate restoring the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager environment from a backup. Oracle provides an extensive number of resources which you can use to find out more about this subject and others. For more videos on Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager, go to the Learning Library link shown. To view an extensive collection of training content covering a range of administrative topics on Oracle Linux, go to the Oracle Linux Learning Library. You can find documentation on Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager at the link shown. There is a comprehensive Oracle Linux curriculum available to support a full range of Linux administration skills for cloud, on-premise, and hybrid users. And for more information or to get started on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, go to cloud.oracle.com. And for more training on Linux and Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, go to the link shown here. That's the end of the video. Thanks for watching.